I'm Mike Birbiglia, and I'm a comedian, an author now, and I had a one-man show off-Broadway last year called Sleepwalk With Me, and now I have a book called Sleepwalk With Me and Other Painfully True Stories.
At boarding school, lying is something of a way of life. There was this guy who in our class, and he was like a legendary liar. His name was Keith Robbins, and he used to lick his fingers like a bookie. And he would dart his eyes from side to side, and he would go, yeah, yeah, nice, nice. And he wasn't even handling money. Like, I don't even know what that was about exactly. And he would lie about insignificant things. You know, he'd be like, yeah, my uncle's Tony Robbins, motivational speaker. Yeah, nice, nice. And like, we found out that that wasn't even true. But even if that were true, it wouldn't be that impressive, which is kind of a Jedi level of lying, is you lie about the small stuff and then people don't know you're lying about the big stuff. It's like banking.
When you're performing, your job is to kind of put the audience in your shoes when you tell them stories, and you can do it with pauses and a look or a gesture or a physicality, and when you hand someone a book, you can't really do that. It all has to be there. One of the things that sometimes I'll do when I'm telling stories is a story will be so strange and that the audience will, instead of laughing, will kind of gasp. And as a result, I developed this mechanism where if they gasp, I'll go, I know. You know, I'm in the future also. And you can't really do that in a book. It doesn't really make a lot of sense to say, I know, I'm in the future also. It's very confusing.
We both believe that on vacation that you shouldn't do anything. Yeah, I'm trying to get quorum on this. Some people disagree with this. I'd recently gone on a trip with my friend Ptolemy to France, and we were in France for like a few days, and it's like 4 p.m. one day, and I lie down on the hotel bed, and I close my eyes, and my friend Ptolemy is like, what are you doing? And I was like, I'm taking a nap. And he was like, you can take a nap in America. We're in France. I was like, I'm taking a nap in France.
To be a comedian, you have to be delusional because, you know, particularly starting out, there's so much failure. And amidst that failure, you have to tell yourself it's going quite nicely, you know, because if you didn't, you wouldn't get on stage again. You know, you just think, I guess human beings don't like me, you know, because, you know, stand-up comedy, it's not like a play or a movie where if people don't like it, people go, well, we didn't like the set or the costumes. With stand-up comedy, if people don't like it, they're basically saying, we don't like you. You know, your personality. And that's hard. That's a hard reality to face. You have to be a little bit delusional.
Everybody at All Boys Catholic School had already lost their mouth virginity. And so I had to lie to my peers and tell them that I had as well. And, you know, they'd be like, have you ever had your first kiss? I'd just be like, yeah. Yeah, of course. Lots of times. And I always feared that they'd ask follow-up questions. They'd be like, oh yeah? What's it like? And I'd be like, it's just like licking an ice cream cone. And they'd be like, no, it's not. It's like sucking on a rocket pop. And I'd be like, ah, wrong frozen dessert analogy.
Ultimately, what I'm trying to do tonally is do things that comedically are telling a story and using comedy as a means to an end, like not an end in itself. You know, like my real pet peeve in comedy is when you go to a comedy film or watch a comedy show and you're laughing at the end of it. You just go, and there's the credits, and you're just like, that's it? That's why we're here, just for nothing? You know, whereas, like, you look at, like, you know, James Brooks films, you know, like Broadcast News or Terms of Endearment or the middle Woody Allen films, like Annie Hall and Manhattan, where it's so funny, it's as funny as anything you'd see, and then at the end of it, it's just heartbreaking. And that's, to me, the goal in everything, is why not do that?